Hello and welcome to Life Effects, the channel where I do stuff with effect. And today, we make this. I already imported my footage into Premiere Pro, and here you can see my glorious creation, the Throne of Green. This is of course not the best setting, but I wanted to take this test footage as quickly as possible. When I'm doing this for the final version, I put a bit more effort in. There will be costumes and proper lighting, but for now, this is good enough. As I mentioned in the last episode, I wanted to try putting guards and the prisoner inside of the helicopter. So I opened the box with all my movie props and played around a bit. Now I have to go through the video file to find the exact pieces which I could use for the helicopter. The shortcut for doing this in Premiere Pro is Command K. Now look at that, isn't that great acting? I'm not yet sure which parts I will use, but since this is placeholder footage, it doesn't matter too much. This position is for the first soldier you see in the helicopter, and I just go ahead and copy this and bring it directly to After Effects. I've chosen three pieces and now I have to key them out. For that I pre-compose it, move all attributes, and this will be the first soldier. There are several methods how to do this, but this one is my favorite. It helps to counter a bad lighting setup. And this is how it works. You duplicate your footage and then put key light on the top layer. Next, you pick the screen color you want to key out. And of course, we can't see any difference. We have to change the view mode to screen matte. As you can see, the key is pretty good, but not ideal. Since this layer is only used as a track matte for the layer below, I can go crazy with these settings. My only goal here is to make everything here that should be visible totally white, while the background stays black. And of course, I thought everything through, so the green screen doesn't cover the whole screen. That's why I have to do a garbage mask that is more precise at the legs. When I do this in the final version, I of course try to build a much bigger green screen setup, so everything is covered. Now that the screen matte is as decent as it gets, I switch to track matte for the lower layer to luma matte. That seems to be pretty good. But it's easier to see with a background. So I quickly create a solid and put it at the bottom. As I said, this is just a placeholder, so I only go over it briefly and keyframe the mask path where it's really necessary. Now I can add the keyed footage into my main composition. But to find the right place for it, I activate the top view again. The window is at this point, so I have to make sure that the position matches the seat of the helicopter model. And I do that by creating a 3D null from the element 3D layer. Now I can move the null layer to the exact place where I want the soldier to sit. next step is to open the position from the soldier layer and also from the null layer. Copy the position information from the null to the soldier and voila, his general orientation matches the null. For good measures, I also pick whip the soldier to the null. In this situation, it's not necessary. But just in case I do want to move the helicopter, after all, the footage will follow the helicopter. So now here's the important part. Of course I have to put the soldier behind the frame of the model. Usually I would have to rotoscope, but thanks to the features of Element there's a much better way. And for that I make another copy of my Element layer and place it on top. And of course the soldier is not visible anymore. But now I can go to the output setting and switch it to Zdepth. This creates a Z-pass which delivers the depth information I need to control the visibility of my footage. For it to work, I need to put the soldier's track mat to luma mat, and of course the mat itself has to be put off. And there you have it! No rotoscoping needed! Further down the road you would have to do some more work to composite the green screen footage with the environment, a light wrap for example. But I set this aside until I record the real footage. For this episode, I only want to do another test with two guards and the prisoner in the back. So I go ahead and create a new 3D now. Grab the composition for the next soldier. And since I want him to sit on the left side, I just flip the layer. First I bring the null to the position where I want the soldier to sit. Adjusting the size and the position. First I bring the null to the position where I want the soldier to sit. And I do the same thing with the third soldier. But now that I have the first overlapping, I kind of see a problem here. As you can see, the soldier in the front is getting transparent, and I'm not quite sure why that's the case. I will have to come back to this. But first, I put in the prisoner layer. Activating the luma mat once again, and the Z-pass does what it should. The layer is obscured by the frame of the helicopter, that's what I wanted. But you can see once again the green screen footage is getting transparent in front of the background. I'm pretty sure it has something to do with Element's Z-pass. Perhaps you can help me find the solution for this problem. But I'm sure I will figure it out until next episode. I see you next time.